Can we have the next question from the brother's side?
I am Mr. Kumar, a profession by teaching. This is my question. I see in Sri Lanka and India, there are many divisions among the Muslims, but they follow the same, the Holy Quran and the follow of the Hadith. But even though they are following the same matters, there are many divisions in Sri Lanka as well as in India. So I would like to get a better reply. I waited till the right person to come at the right time. Please go ahead.
Brother Kumar has asked a very good question, very important question. He says that Muslims in Sri Lanka and India and other parts of the world, they believe in same God, they believe in the same Quran, they believe in same Hadith. But why are the different division? Why are the different sects? The reply is given in the Quran, in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 103. It says, وَاتَثِيمُ بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمْيَا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُ. Hold to the rope of Allah strongly and be not divided. The rope of Allah, the rope of Almighty God is the Quran. So Quran says, hold strongly to the rope of God, to the rope of Allah, the glorious Quran, and the Sahih Hadith, and be not divided. So in Islam, there should not be any divisions. Furthermore, the Quran says in Surah An'am, chapter number 6, verse number 159, that, O Prophet, if anyone makes divisions, sects in the religion of Islam, O Prophet, you have nothing to do with him. Allah will look after his affair on the day of judgment. So making divisions, making sects in Islam is haram. It is prohibited. That's the reason what you find, I do know, that there are many Muslims who have different names, but the right name you should call is only Muslim. And all Muslims should follow the glorious Quran and the Sahih authentic Hadith. Any scholar says anything, if it matches with the Quran and Sahih Hadith, you have to follow. If it does not match, you should throw it away. To make different organizations, to make different organizations, some want to work in the field of education, some want to work in the field of religion, some want to help the poor, there's no problem. Doing Jama'ah, making different organizations, no problem. But as a deen, as a religion, we cannot be divided. There can be no sects. The Quran says we should not make sects. But our beloved Prophet Muhammad said, it's Hadith, the Sahih Hadith of Tirmidhi, Hadith number 171. Beloved Prophet said that there will be 73 sects in the religion of Islam. The Prophet did not say you should make. Allah says don't make, but Prophet said there will be. Unfortunately, we Muslims are divided. And the Prophet predicted that. The people asked that, and the Prophet said only one will go to Jannah, only one will go to paradise. The Prophet asked who? I mean the Sahabas, the companion asked who? The Prophet said those that will follow me and will follow the Quran. That follows the Quran and my example. Today, unfortunately, we have different sects. Shia, Sunni, Hanafi, Shafi, Hanbali, Deobandi, Barevli. What was the beloved Prophet? There is no Shia in the Quran. What was the beloved Prophet? Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a Muslim. The Quran says in Surah Al-Imran chapter 3 verse number 64, قَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Say that I'm a Muslim. Anyone who says a Muslim, Muslim is a person who submits his will to God. Any scholar says anything, all the four great Aimmat, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi, all of these four great scholars, they said, if you find any of my fatwa which goes against Allah and His Rasul, you throw my fatwa on the wall. Therefore I say, whatever Dr. Zakir Naik says in Islam is zero. What I say is zero, what you have to follow is Quran and Sahih Hadith. Therefore, all my answers are backed with Quran and Sahih Hadith. Chapter number so and so, verse number so and so. All these four great scholars, we love them all. We respect them all. They never came to make sects or divisions. They came for people to understand the religion better. But unfortunately, the followers, they started making divisions. Unfortunately. What we have, any scholar says anything, if it matches with the Quran and the Sahih Hadith, you obey, otherwise reject it. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Nisa, chapter 4, 59, Atiullah, Atiur Rasul, obey Allah and obey the Messenger. And it says, and those who have been given the power of commandment, Ulil Amr, those who have been given the power of a commandment, That means those who are knowledgeable people, the shuyukhs, the ulama, follow Allah, follow the messengers, and those who have been given knowledge. But it does not end there. It continues. If the people with knowledge, if they differ, go back to Allah and His Rasul. If two scholars say something, if they differ, go back to Allah and His Rasul. Check what the Quran says. Check what the Sahih Hadith says. Therefore, if you ask me, what am I? I say, I'm a Muslim. I'm first a Muslim. I'm last a Muslim. I follow the Quran and the Sahih Hadith. Anyone says anything, if it matches with Quran and Sahih Hadith, I follow it. If it's a deviation because of culture, because of the land, because this country has a different culture, India has a different culture, Sri Lanka has a different culture, Pakistan has a different culture. Don't follow culture, follow Quran, the saying of Allah the Creator, and the correct saying of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. If it is not available in the Quran and the Sahih Hadith, it is not part of our deen. If it is proven from the Quran and Sahih Hadith, it is our deen. So Islam is only one, and there should not be division in this religion. Hope this answers the question, brother. Can we have the next question from the brother's side?
I am Mr. Kumar, a profession by teaching. This is my questions. I see in Sri Lanka and India, there are many divisions among the Muslims, but they follow the same, the Holy Quran and the follow of the Hadith. But even though they are following the same matters, there are many divisions in Sri Lanka as well as in India. So I would like to get a better reply. I waited till the right person to come at the right time. Please go ahead.
Brother Kumar has asked a very good question, very important question. He says that Muslims in Sri Lanka and India and other parts of the world, they believe in same God, they believe in the same Quran, they believe in same Hadith, but why are the different division, why are the different sects? The reply is given in the Quran, in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 103. It says, وَاتَثِيمُ بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمْيَا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold to the rope of Allah strongly and be not divided. The rope of Allah, the rope of Almighty God is the Quran. So Quran says, hold strongly to the rope of God, to the rope of Allah, the glorious Quran, and the Sahih Hadith, and be not divided. So in Islam, there should not be any divisions. Furthermore, the Quran says in Surah An'am, chapter number 6, verse number 159, that, O Prophet, if anyone makes divisions, sects in the religion of Islam, O Prophet, you have nothing to do with him. Allah will look after his affair on the Day of Judgment. So making divisions, making sects in Islam is haram. It is prohibited. That's the reason what you find, I do know that there are many Muslims who have different names, but the right name you should call is only Muslim. And all Muslims should follow the glorious Quran and the Sahih authentic Hadith. Any scholar says anything, if it matches with the Quran and Sahih Hadith, you have to follow. If it does not match, you should throw it away. To make different organizations, some want to work in the field of education, some want to work in the field of religion, some want to help the poor, there's no problem. Doing Jama'ah, making different organizations, no problem. But as a deen, as a religion, we cannot be divided. There can be no sects. The Quran says you should not make sects, but our beloved Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, it's Hadith, the Sahih Hadith of Tirmidhi, Hadith number 171. Beloved Prophet said that there will be 73 sects in the religion of Islam. The Prophet did not say you should make, Allah says don't make, but Prophet said there will be. Unfortunately, we Muslims are divided. And the Prophet predicted that. The people asked, and the Prophet said, only one will go to Jannah, only one will go to paradise. The Prophet asked who? The Sahabas, the companion asked who? The Prophet said, those that will follow me and will follow the Quran, that follows the Quran and my example. Today, unfortunately, we have different sects: Shia, Sunni, Hanafi, Shafi, Hanbali, Deobandi, Barevli. What was the beloved Prophet? There is no Shia in the Quran. What was a beloved Prophet? A beloved Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was a Muslim. The Quran says in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse number 64, Qala innani minal Muslimin. Say that I'm a Muslim. anyone who says a Muslim, Muslim is a person who submits his will to God. Any scholar says anything, all the four great Aimmah, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi, all of these four great scholars, they said, if you find any of my fatwa which goes against Allah and His Rasul, you throw my fatwa on the wall. Therefore, I say, whatever Dr. Zakir Naik says in Islam is zero. What I say is zero, what you have to follow is Quran and Sahih Hadith. Therefore, all my answers are backed with Quran and Sahih Hadith. Chapter number so and so, verse number so and so. All these four great scholars, we love them all. We respect them all. They never came to make sects or divisions. They came for people to understand the religion better. But unfortunately, the followers, they started making divisions. Unfortunately. What we have, any scholar says anything, if it matches with the Quran and the Sahih Hadith, you obey, otherwise reject it. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Nisa, chapter 4, 59, Atiullah, Atiur Rasul, obey Allah and obey the Messenger. And it says, and those who have been given the power of commandment, Ulil Amr, those who have been given the power of commandment, that means those who are knowledgeable people, the shuyukhs, the ulama, follow Allah, follow the messengers, and those who have been given knowledge. But it does not end there. It continues. If the people with knowledge, if they differ, go back to Allah and His Rasul. If two scholars say something, if they differ, go back to Allah and His Rasul. Check what the Quran says. Check what the Sahih Hadith says. Therefore, if you ask me, what am I? I say, I'm a Muslim. I'm first a Muslim. I'm last a Muslim. I follow the Quran and the Sahih Hadith. Anyone says anything, if it matches with Quran and Sahih Hadith, I follow it. If it's a deviation because of culture, because of the land, because this country has a different culture, India has a different culture, Sri Lanka has a different culture, Pakistan has a different culture, don't follow culture, follow Quran, the saying of Allah the Creator, and the correct saying of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. If it is not available in the Quran and the Sahih Hadith, it is not part of our deen. If it is proven from the Quran and Sahih Hadith, it is our deen. So Islam is only one, and there should not be division in this religion. Hope this answers the question, brother.